Hello everyone, you are watching Dorukhan. Today we are in the Millennial, and as you can see here, I actually managed to collect more than 16,000 points. Why you might ask? For this is actually going to be my fifth match with the same deck that has been suggested to me by my dear subscriber Sebastian Gralian, with him voting. The deck that is to be featured is Karnes Veridian's bulky infantryman with 9 cards that are all either bulky or infantryman. We achieve 180% additional points for our melee duel progress, and this will be my fourth match. Up until now I managed to collect 1271, 2204, 3010 and 2412 points, and around average of 2100-ish points progress has been made. Each match were approximately around 5 minutes, so for my calculations I think in just 60 minutes I'm going to finish this millennial event with this deck. The same can apply to you too if you wish to use such a deck with all melee, all infantry deck. Once again I thank you for Sebastian for his request and suggestion and his vote, and let's go ahead and deploy this deck. I was fortunate enough to have Servants of the Emperor in a relatively low trophies, and hence I have managed to match against easier and healthier opponents. Healthier by mean I have faced against one Captain Ekran and one Shadow Sun players, who as you may expect have more by their special rules, either have themselves more health or heal their cards so that we can actually hit them more with our melee and hence generate more points in the end. And we are against a Urien Rakart, so, who once again with his special rule gets to heal his cards, so we need to hit more, so we need to generate more points. In the previous at the end of previous match I hit 16,583, so I think this match will not only generate us a lot of points but also be quite challenging, for we are against a Urien Rakart. Also has, as you can see, around 150 more trophies than us. So let's go. We have the initiative, so they are relatively slow. I am expecting them to have some homunculi units here and there. I was actually reluctant to use Eisenhorn right away. Also, I can simply ignore this card too. He can heal as much as he wants. With the level 9 Parasite Engine is a powerhouse. Okay, I think they have advantage in nearly all types of attacks, so let us go ahead and buff our own melee by going psychic, for they also had the advantage on the ranged courtesy of this Drukhari Reaver's outflank ability, tier 2 or 3, I think it was 2. And our taunt is unfortunately over, however we are going to be able to kill the Banshee Exarch. Our Eisenhorn will be hit, however our taunt unit survived with just 1 HP to make 1 melee attack, which is lovely. Also with our taunt card that our Eisenhorn made yet another attack, which is lovely and lovely. This card is going to make an attack of 78. I should heal. I should most definitely heal. I should heal, yeah. Or should I? I think I am simply going to switch. But this unit isn't really someone that I want in front of my Eversor. Of. That's really off. Okay, someone really needs to die right now. And unfortunately they didn't. And yeah, this Latrangil unit will actually going to take out Eisenhorn and I'm not happy. And they actually run out of units in here. Yeah. Okay, that's quite weird. Now, I can go melee. I can go ranged. Yeah, I can do this and actually can save my Eisenhorn. But what will saving Eisenhorn achieve me? I mean, I need to kill Latrangil one way or not, but I think I'm going to take this shot. That wasn't really cool. Can you heal more than 40? I do wonder. Yeah, that's really sad. That's really sad right now, and I actually am sad that I didn't made an attack. I think Valoris should deploy and kill. However, yeah, with Valoris killing that unit, I think I should go ranged right now. Yes. Okay. Adeptus Custodes Shield Captain will be able to take down the Parasite Engine with its ranged attack. And we will have Yuri Indrakar in our hands with the facing Eversor Assassin, which is acceptable. Yeah, they can heal their units, I don't really care. I have two more runs to make three attacks on my enemy. And I will simply chip away Rakard. Yeah, this is progressing smoothly. And I'm also building my melee and I'm planning to unleash it on the next round. Oh, they have selected Psychic, okay. They are chickening out. They also have a relatively strong melee boost thanks to going Psychic this round, I believe. Yeah, I can go, however, yeah, they can go with their melee, however, they shouldn't have enough, right? Around 61-ish. I am hoping right now. Okay, they are hitting this. Okay. Calculations correct. Yeah, that would be a disaster. That's not nice! No! Yeah. I really needed that retaliation attack. I am sorry if that was not pleasant for your ears. However, it was unpleasant for my heart. So, I believe I should put Valoris on the left. However, can I buy any more time in this scenario? Sorry about the background noise, for I am in a third world country. Okay. Now, I still cannot reach the necessary little melee damage. However, I think the next round we should achieve. Yep, they are going psychic, for they know they can't hit. I also happen to have this Avatar of Yinead, the Yinkarn card at level 2. Of course, not as strong as this. However, no matter the level, I think this card is simply too expensive to be of use. I don't think this opponent had 8 bodyguards in their deck, hence their fate has been sealed. If you are a Rakard player, I highly advise you to include 8 card, guys. 8 card is the key. More healing done, no matter the copy number or the strength of a single card, Simply include as much as card as you can to get more value out of your Yinra cards passive. However, thanks to their bad deck construction, in my honest opinion, this episode was especially exciting for me. I hope the same applied for you as well. And yeah, 50 is the key, guys. This was the fifth match I have recorded with the Karnes Viridian. We also got 5 skulls and 76 trophies, in my opinion, is relatively nice. Yeah, only 18 points short to hit the final. And yeah, I actually managed to complete a quest about ranged attacks in trying to make a melee duel. However, considering we were matched against a heavy melee record, it was expected, and we managed to hit the 7th stage. Nice. 140. Okay, and we are in the 19,000, I always make the same mistake, 173 points. How many did we increase from 16,583 to 2,590, guys, let's say 2,600, more than 2.5k points with a single match. Exceptionally nice deck. Also, I think developers are trying to tell us such keyword decks do tend to go along. You can make such a deck. I also do not know how much does this deck have in initiative. It has a relatively fast initiative considering it only has infantrymen. Not many bulky as well. Only 2, if I'm not mistaken. So initiative is nice. You go first. Going first is most of the time, and for most of the players is nice. I do prefer it as well. Gets you more strategy and planning. One step further. And yeah, 5 matches. All 5 means, of course, we were in a relatively lower placement. However, as you can see, starting from in these 1800-ish, 1900-ish trophies, for my account level and card copy numbers, the game has been started to become more challenging. However, we did pull through with this bulky infantryman deck an episode. And I hope this deck has entertained you, for it entertained me, while also letting me progress a lot in this melee duel. And I am looking forward to invest all these lovely gold to really cool and nice decks that is to be featured in this channel as well. And up until that moment, I would love you to take good care of yourselves and finish this melee duel and collect every single penny of gold available in this challenge to be ready for more campaigns, for more ranked duels, and more funny stuff. See ya.